Here at the Holy See delegation in Geneva, a speech is being prepared. Dr. Carlo Maria Marenghi, who is also a lecturer in international law at Webster University, assists Archbishop Ivan Jurkovic with the preparation of his statement that needs to be delivered later that day to the United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, in short, UNCTAD. The topic, trade and development in light of the COVID-19 crisis. In the spirit of the Catholic Church, the Holy See focuses on those whose lives and livelihoods are more severely affected, namely people in the developing world. Today's session will be only virtual, and that means for the Holy See that the Archbishop records his speech on his laptop, online, directly into the audio recording system of the UN.
The roots of this crisis are not only economic and financial, but above all moral in nature. Recognizing the primacy of being over having and of ethics over economy, the world's people ought to adopt an ethic of solidarity to fuel their actions.
But are moral principles, in a mainly profit-driven world, even possible?
Simply, to answer these questions in a very simple way, they are not only possible, they are obligatory. We have a better world because we comply with these rules and we comply with standards. Usually this is considered only as a juridically, how to say, we respect the law, but we don't care about ethics and victorian morals. But everybody knows that the real respect of law is possible only if you have somebody who stays behind the law with a moral attitude. I remember only one thing. I was living for a long time in Eastern Europe, and I remember changes that happened after the end and collapse of Soviet Union. And the foreign companies that were coming to these countries, many of them were exploring, first of all, the human quality, not the capacity, not the infrastructure, but the human quality. When you have a good human quality, when you have people who are morally and ethically responsible, you will make a good investment, you will have a good business.
Echoing Pope Francis, the Holy See delegation demanded immediate actions of the international community to relieve the burden and struggle of crisis-stricken developing countries.
In light of the present circumstances, the Holy See urges that all nations be put in the position to meet the greatest needs
of the moment through the reduction, if not the forgiveness, of the debt burdening the balance sheets.
The balance sheet of the poorest nations. These are words of Pope Francis.
Pope Francis is often being accused that his economic and social ideas and criticism of capitalism have the taste of Marxism. But a closer look reveals that he is actually reflecting the social doctrine of the Roman Catholic Church. And according to Pope Francis, this does not mean being Marxist.
But what is the responsibility of the Church and of the Gospel, let's say, is that we are always concerned about the fact that we are living together on a limited space, on a limited resources, and we have to always keep in mind somebody that's behind us. If we take too much, the other is going to be without. And this is the enormous intuition, I think, of the Pope that is leading and somehow defining his pontificate.
As hope is one of the three theological virtues in Christian tradition, hope needs to be practiced, especially today, for a future good, difficult but possible to attain, as Catholic philosopher Thomas Aquinas defined it.
We have to accept the fact that mankind, the human society, is resourceful. Mankind will find ways to get out. And I think the religious institution, church and other organizations, we will do everything that also we will maintain in high attention to the fact that somebody are not privileged. We are going to do our best in order to show to everybody that we are voice of those who have no voice, and we are going to attract the attention to this fact.
The Holy See informed the United Nations that they are in the process of writing a position paper that they will present during the next UNCTAD ministerial conference. The paper will alarm the international community not to abandon those who live on the brink of every part of the world during this pandemic.